Well, you know, it's a lot better than last year. Let's put it that way. It all came out with a demon over our head from last year. But no, liked a lot of things about it. The tempo of the kids, the conditioning looked like we were in good shape. And, you know, we made some plays down the field. In the second half, we opened it up and said, let's throw it around and see some of the kids make plays. Too many pre-snap penalties, and that was all groups, threes, two, ones. It wasn't just all one group. You know, you can't beat yourself. This was a great scrimmage because we got to evaluate some personnel. Now from here, we'll take a good look at that. And then from here, we got to start getting more situational based. Can we move the chains on third down? One of our nemesis last year. I think we'll have a good run game. I think we got some kids that can really run the ball. And our line is gelling. So we'll get the evaluation of the personnel and now really start, you know, honing on those situations that will make us successful in games.
Todd, it seemed like you guys gave the kind of the three and four backs a lot of look in terms of Marcus and Battles, and it seemed like Shaw responded pretty well.
Yeah, we wanted to give those first group kids, you know, a handful of plays and get them out. Murray played a lot last year. Daryl's been running hard. We know what he has behind him. So those young kids were kind of searching for that third guy, so to speak, right now. And so we want to throw them the fire, give them a bunch of reps. How do they handle fatigue? How do they handle getting hit? And so I was proud of Marcus. Obviously made some exciting runs. He's got a ton of talent. Still has a bunch of development to do, on all-around game things. But had a good day.
Quarterbacks as a whole, you felt like they handled the pace of it pretty well?
Yeah, you know what? You know, we missed some things here and there, but, you know, no real dumb mistakes. Threw some deep balls that gave guys a chance to make a play. We missed a couple, but one or two. But overall, you know, just the naked eye, it looks like they had pretty good command of what we were doing. We didn't see a lot of pressure on third down, which would be the toughest thing for them to catch up with. But I was pleased just, you know, seeing it happen full speed, how they handled themselves.
Who on defense was disruptive for you? Who showed up today that you saw?
You know, when our younger kids went, Claude Davis came off the end. He's a physical talent kid that, you know, gave our tackles a tough time. Inside that second group, they had a little bit of push with Sager and some of those kids that disrupted some of our inside runs. I think they run well on defense, just the team speed. We had some things on the perimeter where they turn and run, and it looks like you're going to get six, seven, eight, and you get three. And, you know, they ran to the ball hard as a defense, just not a group. I thought they did a good job of that.
Any receivers stand out to you from today?
Yeah, you know, I thought, Deontay Welch made a nice jump ball catch, caught a shallow route, turned up the corner. It was good to see Love. In the first, he caught a slant in traffic. You know, he caught a jump ball down here on the sideline. You know, a lot of guys showed me things here and there, but as a group, coming out of it will be interesting. I think some of the freshmen have done great things, and Andre and Ruben. I think they got a little tired today, the pace of it. You know, had a chance to maybe make a play down the field and just were fatigued. But overall, that group's really improved. Sterling Griffin's had a great fall camp. Today had a couple things maybe come his way, not a ton. But he's a guy that's impressed us from day one to today.